Welcome back to Let's Play Final Fantasy VII. In the last episode, we went to this room. It was kind of like a puzzle room, and we had to like chase that guy, and we chased him, and we won. So, apparently through that door we just opened, we can go to the next part of the story, and there's a boss over there. But before we do any of that, we still have a couple rooms in this clock room place we haven't done, so yeah, I'm just gonna go ahead and try to figure this out. Yeah, so we're just gonna explore the last couple of rooms before we go ahead with the story, because I A, don't want to miss anything, and B, I don't really have time to record more story stuff in this episode, because I imagine there's gonna be like a bunch of cutscenes and it's gonna take up multiple episodes. And I just kind of want to record one video today, and then tomorrow I'm going to record a bunch of videos, so. Alright, the second hand has passed. Let's go into room number 7. I imagine this will be important, since, you know, the game has a 7 in it, so. Alright, let's see, treasure chest. We got the trumpet shell. Alright. Let's go ahead and see. Equip trumpet shell. What is that? Not really sure. Trumpet shell? I might have to just look that up in the little inventory we got here. Alright, scrolling to the bottom. Trumpet shell. Oh, that's for Kate Sith. Never using that guy again. Don't know why you gave me that game. Silly game. Also, we're a little low on HP, so I'm just gonna go ahead and do that. I don't think we'll be finding any more stuff in this episode, but, you know, we'll see. Also, at the end of this episode, I'm gonna be rearranging some equipment and whatnot, because if there is a boss in that, next little segment, then I'm gonna need to equip some actual stuff to Aeris, because right now I just equipped, like, whatever, but I should give her, like, a proper setup, so. Alright, let's see what's in this room. More and more treasure! Got a Mega Elixir. Alright, well that's pretty self-explanatory. I don't need to go and look up what that does. Actually, you know what? Let's go ahead and look up what that does. I'm pretty sure it just, like, restores everything. Mega Elixir. Mega Elixir, where are you? I just want to double check to see what that does. Fully restores all members' HP and MP. Okay, so basically, the best item you can get. We're gonna be saving that for, like, I don't know, the final boss or something. Something crazy like that. Alright, we have one room left, actually. Alright. Go back time, foreign time. Yeah. If I can just move it around. There we go. Alright, so let's see what's through door number 9. Alright. Anything? Nothing. There's nothing through door number 9. Alright, so, question, can we ever go through any of these, like, rock doors? Because I don't know if we can. Alright, I guess we will go through that door in this episode, because, honestly, there's nothing else to do. There's just nothing else to do. I was expecting some, like, boss fights or, like, something, but no. Guess we're just gonna go through this area. Now, before I do that, gonna change up a few things. Let's see, carbon bangle. You can have that one. The gem ring seems pretty good, so I'm gonna give you that. And yeah, let's actually equip some good stuff. Arrange, exchange. Oh, that reminds me of that one Foo Fighters song. What is it? Erase, Replace? It's a good song. Alright, I want to keep Aeris in our party for a little while longer, so I'm gonna go ahead and switch out some stuff. Also, I'm having a bit of a problem with my controller, so it keeps, like, going up. Like, I'm not doing that. I'm gonna have to fix that between episodes. Hopefully it won't be a huge problem during a battle. Enemy skill, steel, sense. Alright, I'm gonna go ahead, I'm gonna give you sense, because that's useful. And you can also have gravity. Let's see, elemental? Elemental is good. Mental poison. Time. Time is really useful, so you can have that too. You can have all the good things. And barrier. You know what, barrier? That's rather fitting for you, honestly. Yeah, that's actually a not bad setup. I don't really need, like, the luck plus, but oh well. Once again, like, should I have Tifa still be the healer? I don't know, because I've always had her be the healer. Wait, revive restore, okay. Eris only has a little bit more MP, so Tifa can still be the healer. You can both do healing. Eris has her limit break, so. Alright, the only thing left to do is, can you heal me in some way? Rest, okay. I just wanted to restore my MP there. And everyone seems all good to go. I'm gonna go ahead and make an extra save, and then we're gonna go through the door. Maybe I will record a couple of videos today. I hope I don't miss the thing I was planning on doing. My favorite streamer is doing a stream tonight, but of course he doesn't say what time it is, so. Alright, let's see what's in this room. Lots of nice, what are they called? Hieroglyphics? This is the room with the murals. Where are you, Sephiroth? Oh, there he is. He looks, doubled. Is there two of him? Are they copies? So cold. If it's so cold, then, I mean, you're right next to a fire. I'm always by your side. Come. Alright, so I think Sephiroth wants to fight us or something. Splendid. Sephiroth is kind of cool, TBH. Just putting that out there. Although, if you're one of those crazy people who, like, wants to be Sephiroth, I don't know what to tell you, because you can't be him. A treasure house of knowledge. I don't understand what you're saying. Of course you wouldn't, Cloud. You don't understand a lot of things. Is he gonna be up ahead again? We're just gonna keep, like, running into him. Oh, look, a meteor thing falling from the sky. Look well. At what? At that which adds to the knowledge of. I am becoming one with the planet. Okay, that is not a proper sentence, Sephiroth. Are those two separate thoughts? Because you should finish the first thought before you start talking about that second thought there. Alright. Why is he just lying down? Mother, it's almost time. Soon we will become one. Sephiroth, I think you need a therapist. I mean, you only talk in riddles, you're always carrying around a weapon, you're a little mentally unstable. How do you intend to become one with the planet? Jump into a pit of lava. That sounds reasonable. It's simple. Once the planet is hurt, gather spirit energy to heal the injury. Okay, I guess that makes sense. Amount of energy gathered depends on the size of the injury. So Sephiroth is going to kill everyone to save the planet. is that the plan? What would happen if the injury that threatened the very life of the planet? How much energy would be gathered? Lots of it. In the center of that injury will be me. All that boundless energy will be mine. By merging with all the energy of the planet, I will become a new life form, a new existence. Melding with the planet, I will cease to exist as I am now, only to be reborn as a god, to rule every soul. An injury powerful enough to destroy the planet, injure the planet. Behold that mural, the ultimate destructive magic, meteor. That'll never happen. Wake up. You know, Sephiroth, you should stop flying around everywhere. We're gonna chase after him, I guess. Where did you go, though? Cloud, what's wrong? Are you laughing? Are you cold? Why are you shaking like that? Hey, Cloud. What is happening? Ha ha ha, Black Materia. Call Meteor. Cloud, get a hold of yourself. Did Sephiroth, like, take over Cloud or something? I'm Cloud. How should I? Cloud doesn't seem alright. Seems to be, a bit concentrated on something. I remember my way. Don't lose your way. Cloud? What's wrong? Is something wrong? It's nothing, so don't worry about it. Right, Cloud, it's nothing. Sephiroth got away. Don't worry about it. I understand what he was saying. So this must be Meteor, right? Something's gonna fall from the sky. Alright, so from what I understand, Sephiroth is going to summon a meteor, or like, I don't know, grab one from outer space, destroy the planet so it will kill everyone, and then he can like rule over their energies or something. This must be magic, just what Sephiroth was saying. The ultimate destructive magic, Meteor. It finds small drifting planets with its magic. Then collides with them. This planet might get wiped out entirely. Alright, so it's not me. What's not you? Oh, you sent this thing? Ooh, a dragon. Dragon. Alright, I'm gonna do climb hazard right away and you can't do anything about it. Alright, magic, I don't know. You can just do your normal thing. Sense. Gonna sense on it. Man, that did a pretty good amount of damage. Let's see how much HP it has. Let's see. Oh. Hey, it's already like halfway dead. That's funny. Summon Shiva. That would make sense. Magic. I don't know, let's do some bolts. Bolt would be good. Let's see how much Shiva does, or Shiva? No, it's probably Shiva. Shiva doesn't sound like a real word. That's how you know if you're pronouncing something right. If it sounds more like a real word, then say it that way. That's all I can say. Alright, magic, poison. For a second I thought that said Persona, and I'm like, aw, that's the wrong game. Alright, let's see, magic. Ooh, that did a lot. Here, let's just do a cure on everyone. Even though we're not like that badly damaged, but whatever. Magic, bolts, because bolts is pretty good, so why not? And, wait, didn't I give you... Yeah, let's... Oh, never mind. I was like, yeah, I'm gonna do gravity, but it's already dead. Alright. Yeah, that fight went really easily. Dragon Armlet. Thank you. Dragon Armlet is good. Oh, a materia. Does that summon the dragon? Because that would be pretty cool. He disappeared. Alright, well, I'm just gonna go ahead and grab this. Bahamut! Huzzah! Let's go ahead and, can we equip that right now? Oops. No, we're kind of full. Well, I should give it to someone, but... Nah, we'll be fine. I'll equip that eventually. We'll give that a try in one of the coming episodes. We're locked in? What? Okay, there's gotta be a secret way out. Let's see. Oh, there's a floating thing? Hello, floating thing. What does this do? What is this? Cloud has the same question as me. There's something running on it. Black materia. Well, that sure doesn't help us get out of this room. What should we do, Cloud? Shake it? Yeah, let's not take it. Wait a minute, I'll ask. Ask who? I don't understand. Oh, you're asking, like, the ancients or whatever? What? Really? They said that the temple itself is the Black Materia. Okay. It's an awfully big materia. Usually there are these tiny little orbs, a bit smaller than Dragon Balls. What do they mean? So the whole building is the Black Materia, this huge temple. Then no one could take it. It's pretty hard. You see, this is a model of the temple. Inside is a device which gets smaller each time you solve a puzzle. The model becomes smaller too, you become smaller too. Until it's small enough to fit in the palm of your hand. So if we solve the puzzles, the Black Materia will get smaller and smaller and we can take it out. Yes, but there's one thing. You can only answer the puzzles inside the temple. So anyone who solves the puzzle will be crushed by the temple. I see, so the ancients didn't want dangerous magic to be taken out of the temple so easily. Yeah, this sounds like a bit of a predicament. Let's leave it, okay? No, we've got to think of a way to get it out. Let's have Kate Sith do it. He can get crushed. That's not a problem. He was a traitor in the first place, because Sephiroth has a lot of different flunkies. It's nothing to him to throw away lives to get the Black Materia. This place isn't safe. So what should we do? Oh, someone's calling us on our 1997 cell phone. Answer that, Cloud. Hi, Cloud, this is Kate Sith. Oh, it's you. I overheard the whole... How did you overhear the whole story? Did you tap our cell phone? Don't forget about me. Everything you said makes perfect sense. You can use my stuffed body for the future of the planet. Oh yeah, because that's not his real body. We can't let Sephiroth get his hands on the Black Materia. Can't let Shinra get theirs on it either. Cloud, there's nothing else you can do. Everyone, trust me. I guess we have no choice. Alrighty then, leave it to me. Please hurry, you've got to get out of there. I'll be waiting at the exit. Alright, so let's leave, I suppose. Well, Cloud just... That's funny, he like left the scene and then it's just like, oh, but now you're back at the scene anyway. I guess we got a few enemies to fight. Yeah, we'll fight these real quick and then we're gonna end the episode. Bolt on everyone, destroy. Destroy everything. Yeah, bolt two on everyone again. Eris, you can defend, because why not? Alright, decent amount of damage. What does this do? Can we kill them? Nope, they're not dead. Alright, well, we're just gonna... Have we fought these before, by the way? Because I don't remember these specific ones. I remember flying green things in this game, but not these specific flying green things. Yeah, I guess, you know, using that heal all is not a bad idea now that we've taken a bit of damage. I don't know if I'll ever, like... I hear that Eris, her final limit break is, like, extremely OP. Like, it makes everybody invincible for, like, 2 or 3 turns. That sounds like a bit much, but I don't know if we'll actually end up unlocking that. We'll see. We'll see what happens. Alright, Tifa, don't let me down, don't let me down. Yeah, we did it. That's right. We did it, Tifa. We solved the riddle of the hit miss something. I don't know what I'm talking about anymore. I'm just glad that we finally got all 4 to work properly. Meteor dive. Yeah. That did so much damage. Alright. Let's see, drop anything. Oh, ice level up. That's pretty good. Turbo ether, that's really helpful. Alright, let's leave. And okay, we can save here. Alright, so thank you everybody for watching this episode of Final Fantasy VII. In the next episode, we're gonna leave the temple and we're gonna destroy Kate Sith's fake body so we can get the black materia. So yeah, I'll see you all next time.